The chemistry of soil. We often take it for granted that we can find delicious fruit and healthy vegetables from food stores. However, have you ever stopped to think about where all this food comes from? Or what happens in the soil when food is produced? There are things we should be thinking about, because we only have a limited amount of arable soil. In fact, only around 3% of the Earth's surface is arable. The rest consists of waters, mountains, cities, swamps, and deserts. But hey, do you know what soil smells like? From the arable soil, the most important component is the fine-smelling, dark organic matter called humus. Its chemical buildup varies, so it is impossible to define the exact structure of humus. But we can say that humus is moist. It is rich in oxygen. It contains earth metals and contains long chains of organic molecules. Humus also contains an active ecosystem of fungi and insects. In fact, in 1 teaspoon of humus, there is around 100 billion microbes and microorganisms. These little fellows play a very important role in breaking down organic matter so that it can be used as nutrients by plants. But we have a problem. Today, new humus is formed slower than it is used up. The amount of humus is decreasing. Humus is decreasing most significantly due to erosion, in which humus is being washed away from the soil. In the past decades, erosion has increased due to extreme weather conditions, such as droughts and heavy rains, often caused by climate change. Droughts cause the structure of the soil to change, making it more vulnerable to erosion caused by wind and water. Heavy rains can cause significant amounts of soil to be washed away into rivers. Erosion is further increased by certain industrial activities, such as cutting down forests and other vegetation. In addition to erosion, the amount of humus is being decreased due to a decrease of trees and vegetation, monocultural farming methods, where only one type of crop is produced, and chemicals used in agriculture, such as pesticides. So why is this a problem? Having enough humus in the soil is important, because humus is rich in nutrients, and therefore helps maintain the natural cycle of nutrients. Soil that is rich in nutrients increases food safety. Humus decreases erosion, because vegetation that grows on humus helps keep the soil intact. Humus decreases the pollution of water, eutrophication, and climate change, as the microorganisms in humus tie down molecules such as carbon. To understand this in more detail, let's examine the nutrient cycle. The primary nutrients used by vegetation are phosphorus, P, potassium, K, and nitrogen, N. But many other micronutrients are also essential. In the nature, these nutrients are constantly circulated between the soil, plants, and air, and in a balanced ecosystem, there is no deficiency of these nutrients. However, when vegetation is harvested and taken elsewhere, also the nutrients are removed from the land. In order to continue growing crops in the land needs to be fertilized. The majority of these fertilizers currently come from fossil sources, and their production requires large amounts of energy. So where do the nutrients from fertilizers end up? They end up in the manure of farm animals and wash away into waters. This causes the PKN nutrients to be overabundant in animal farms, but scarce in crop farms. So, couldn't we just fertilize the crop farms with manure? Using animal manure as fertilizers is currently not cost-effective because of transportation costs. Furthermore, we have an oversupply of livestock and manure. 2/3 of the Earth's farmland is used for crop-fed animals. So what is the situation with other nutrients? In addition to the primary nutrients, PKN, plants also need other nutrients. Farming land can also cause a deficiency in these other nutrients as crop is harvested. For instance, when harvesting forests, especially calcium and magnesium are lost from the soil, unless branches are left to decompose in the land. The pH of these nutrients is basic, so they also work as buffers, preventing the soil from becoming acidic. These nutrients are also important to humus, as they support the well-being of the microbes involved in the nutrient cycle. For these reasons, especially calcium is often added to farmland. If the acidity of the soil increases, it increases the solubility of harmful metals, increasing the risk of them being washed away into waters. This may cause metals such as aluminum, manganese, lead, mercury, and cadmium to accumulate in the food chain. In other words, organisms would then be eating and drinking reactive metal ions. So how could we help humus foster? What can I do about the issue? There are many things. Do research on what is meant by circular economy and permaculture. How could the principles of circular economy and permaculture be acknowledged in yards and gardens near you? Take a stand and encourage decision makers to take action to maintain the diversity of the nature. Plant trees, as that increases the ability for the soil to tie carbon and other nutrients. Examine sustainable ways to farm and manage forests. This can include examining types of soil, looking for farming plant protein, farming in water, and examining sustainable ways to harvest trees from the forest.